Good morning all. Welcome to the online class of Odisha State Open University. Today we'll be discussing about fee-based services, and that is coming under your MCO 7 block 3. And fee-based services, we will be discussing about the issue management, the corporate advisory services, and about mutual fund, about securitization of assets, and many more things. And the resource person of today's session is Mr. Prithviraj Mishra, sir, and academic consultant, Odisha State Open University. And before starting up the session, I would like to just give a brief headings or brief explanation about today's session. That is, fee-based services are generally offered to corporate clients. Those are cash management services, letter of credits, bank guarantees, bill discountings, forex services, merchant banking, credit rating, etc. So in which we will be studying about unit 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. In unit 10, we will be studying about issue management. So issue management refers to managing the issues of corporate securities, like equity shares, preference shares, debentures, bonds, etc. In unit 11, the topic is corporate advisory services. So advisory services that are actually provided to the various corporate bodies about financial aspects of their operations. Clear? So it is basically professional services which are actually provided to various corporate bodies or corporate entities. And then unit 12 will be covering about unit 12 will be covering about credit rating. So it is an estimate of the ability of a person or organization to fulfill their financial commitments based on their previous dealings. And unit 13, we will be discussing about mutual fund. It's a very popular term, and it is an open-ended, professionally managed investment funds that pools money from any investors to purchase securities. And in the last unit 12, we will be discussing about securitization of assets. So what is mean by securitization? Securitization is the way of raising funds by selling receivables, which are then turned into asset-backed loan and securities. So this method of financing brings various benefits, such as diversification of funding sources, as well as improvement of the cash flow of any organization. So in details, we'll be discussing all these aspects of fee-based services by none other than Mr. Prithviraj Mishra, sir, academic consultant, OSOU. So before starting off this session, I would like to request all the learners to mute their microphones to avoid unusual disturbance during the class, and don't present anything. And if you have any queries or doubts, all your queries will be answered by our resource person at the end of the session. You can type all your doubts in the chat box also, and all the doubts will be discussed at the end of the session. So may I please request Mr. Prithviraj Mishra, sir, to start the session. Please, sir.
Thank you, Kirod Babu, and also the Devasis for supporting this online class. Good morning, everybody. And welcome to this online class organized by Odisha State Open University. My name is Prithviraj Mishra, working as academic consultant, Odisha State Open University. Today we'll be discussing fee-based services, which is a part of management of financial services under Block 3, MCU 7. My colleague and friend, KC Maharana, has already introduced the topic. Friends, see the title, fee-based services. That is, we are not selling or offering any goods, because services, we sell two things, no? Mostly either we are selling goods or we are selling services. When services are offered, rather marketed, or in raw term, we can say that when services are sold, there is nothing called a free launch. That we charge something that is called fee, remuneration, commission, brokerage, etc., etc., in different terms for these services offered. So many services are offered for several types of, professions or tests or jobs, whatever you call it. Here we are concentrating on the fee-based services related to certain features which are marketed in the financial market. We have discussed the vast network of financial market we are having in our country. And we have also discussed the most important market, that is your equity market, debt market, under money market operations or financial market operations. We have also discussed how a company is formed, how the company managed to arrange the various resources required to function or undertake that particular project for which the company has formed, and how the legal formalities are to be complied with in formation of a company or corporation, whatever you call it. Friends, the basic objective of any company or business venture is profit. And to earn that profit and to cater to the interest of the stakeholders, the company requires finance, funding, or money. Company as a vast economic entity won't be able to get the finance from a single individual. It is not a sole proprietorship form of business or partnership form of business. It requires huge funding. Hundreds of crores, thousands of crores are required to undertake the activities which are the objectives of formation of the company. Mostly, the first target is public in general, those who are interested to invest. So we depend on the IPO, that is initial public offer, for mostly equity shares. We know that there are different types of shares, and this is equity. For debt also, planning can be made by the company. Here we are discussing the issue management. How to manage an issue? The issue may be for equity shares, the issue may be for commercial paper, the issue may be for company deposit, the issue may be for debt instruments, the issue may be for PCD, NCD or CD, whatever you call it, or maybe mutual fund also. We are talking generally the management aspects, compliance of legal formalities, dependence on various intermediaries in affecting our issue of what? Issue of shares or debentures, whatever it may be, but mostly we are concentrating on issue of shares, equity shares. Now, coming back to the issue management, then different types of issues are there. We may call it public issue, IPO, initial public offer. We may call it follow-up offer, that is FPO. Second time, after issuance of initial public offer, if you go for the second time, it is called FPO. Then we can also talk about private placement of shares in the QIB route, qualified institutional investors, or profitability route. Or we can also issue, what we call it, rights issue. when we start issuing the shares to the existing shareholders. New players will not be allowed. Basically, the actions to manage the issue in all types of issues are almost same. Somewhere it is more lengthy process, somewhere the process is short. Otherwise, compliance, from the compliance point of view, you have to comply in all the issues, all the requirement as formulated by Securities and Exchange Board of India, SEBI, Indian Companies Act 2013, and your other guidelines of SEBI, that is Securities Regulation or Securities Rules 1956 and 1957 respectively. Friends, if we go through the Companies Act, starting from Section 55 till Section 83 in the old Indian Companies Act 1956, that means almost 28 sections were devoted towards issue management. Legal compliances, apart from the legal compliances of SEBI. So here, initial public offer, as it appears to us, the general investors, it is not that an easy task, and it cannot be handled by the management of the company alone. They require different kinds of intermediaries in it. So, issue management, corporate advisory services, credit rating, mutual funds, and asset securitization have been introduced to you by KC Maharana. We are discussing here issue management. As I told you, issue management, that different types of issues are there, maybe public. Sorry, just a minute. Sorry, issue management, as it is mentioned in your screen, refers to managing issues of corporate securities, equity shares, preference shares, debentures, or bonds. It involves marketing of capital issue, existing company, including rights issue, and dilution of share by letter of offer. Here, one important point is there. Other things are clear. Dilution of share. What does it mean by dilution of shares? It is just like, friends, suppose a single piece of cake is there, having a weight of say 1 kg, and 10 people are there ready to share the cake. So we can say that everybody has got the ownership of 100 grams. The cake will be divided into 10 pieces. Now, another 10 people entered to have a share of the cake. Capital base remains the same. Now, 1 crore share owned by 10 people or one cake weighing 1 kilo, ownership of 10 persons. Now, 20 people will share the cake. So, why this word dilution is used? They have the share of 1 lakh rupees. 100 people are there. Share was 1 lakh rupees each. So 1 crore. Now the capital base will be increased to 2 crores. Say, for example, another 50 people entered or 40 people entered. 40 plus 10. Now, how many shareholders are there? 50 shareholders are there. What is the base? 2 crores. That is, their percentage of ownership of an individual diluted by issuance of further shares. That is why it is called dilution of share. Any new issue, irrespective of the category, once IPO is there, further public offer or further issue of debenture or equity shares dilute the ownership of that particular individual. I have 10% ownership of the company. Now, when the issue of a capital base increased from 1 crore to 2 crores, and another 40 people entered into the fray, total number of shareholders becomes 50. So, what is the percentage? 4%. My ownership was earlier 10%, now reduced to 4%, though I am having the same quantum of shares with me, same numbers of shares with me. I can exercise the same rights, but my ownership is diluted from 10% to 4%. Earlier, I was claiming, or I was boasting that I am the owner of 10% of this company. Now I cannot boast about 10%. I can say that I'm the owner of 4% of this company. That is the meaning of dilution of shares. Thank you, friends. Now, issue management report. What are the critical aspects of issue management? We will be discussing. Here, shares can be issued at par. Par means a 100 rupee share will be issued at 100 rupees. You will have to pay 100 rupees. Issued at a premium when you are paying more. A share of 100 rupees will be marketed, or I mean issued for 125 rupees. This 25 rupees is your premium. Sometimes shares are issued at a discount. 100 rupees share will be issued 90 rupees or 70 rupees or 80 rupees, whatever it may be. Here another term you will come across, that is safety net or buyback of shares. We'll coming back to that intermediary after this. What is safety net? Safety net means, suppose the shares are issued at a premium or at par also, whatever it is. After the shares are listed in the stock exchange, suddenly you find that the value of the share is less than the issue price. You purchase the share for 150 or 125 or 100 rupees, it is not applicable to discount. But once it is listed, the price of the shares in the market becomes 90 rupees. In that case, there is a provision. You can contact the merchant banker or the broker to the issue if safety net provision is there, and you can claim that whatever I have paid initially, please pay me back and take your shares. I have purchased 10 shares at the rate of 150. Okay, so my money, 1500 rupees, you return, I will give your shares back, 10 shares. There is only a rider here. This is applicable to only up to 1000 shares. If you have purchased more than 1000 shares of any company, you can go for the safety net or buyback process for 1000 shares only, not more than that. This is known as safety net, provided to protect the interest of the small investors by Securities and Exchange Board of India. Then coming back, issue, how to go about the issue. Here, what are the things mentioned? Issue managers are required to mainly comply with the following requirements for registration. Before that, how the issue is taken place. Just imagine that you are your son or your brother or your sister is getting married. Marriage ceremony will take place. For organizing a marriage ceremony, what we used to do? So many things are to be done. So many people are required to help us in organizing a marriage ceremony. Fine. We have to advance for the mandap, we had to advance for the crackers, we had to advance for the band party, we have to advance for flowers, we have to advance for electricity, we have to advance for the caterer, we have to or arrange the cooking for the feast, etc., etc. So many things are there. Pandit, okay. Now, suppose you want that so many things, I am a lone person, I cannot handle alone, and I cannot go from place to place, so many people, very difficult on my part. Again, I have to go to the printer to print the invitation cards. I have to distribute the invitation cards. Then I have to tell someone to arrange a pandit. So many things are there. Fine. Now, you will talk with one person. That is known as event manager. Bhai, 500 people will come in the feast. My daughter is getting married. These 500 plus 150 rupees, 50 persons will come with the barat. My budget is this much. These are the items. Tell me, you will do everything. What amount you will take? No, sir. Our total expenditure, I will give you the bills for all expenditure. On the bills, I will take 10%. If my expenditure is, say, 3 lakhs, money he will take 30,000 rupees. 5 lakhs, he will take 50,000 rupees. I am relaxed. Fine, I lost 30,000, 40,000 rupees, that commission part I lost. But then I am relaxed. Things will be done by that gentleman to my satisfaction and expectation. Then over. Just like that, in any issue management, we require the help of certain intermediaries. These intermediaries are important players in affecting the issue management. First of all, when a company decides to go public with an issue, it has to follow certain guidelines outlined by the Securities and Exchange Board of India for offering securities in public issues. Again, the company needs to fulfill certain eligibility criteria, which I have already discussed. There are most importantly, or mostly, four important intermediaries associated with the issue to do separate activities. Again, these intermediaries, which we are going to discuss, most importantly, four intermediaries, they have to register with SEBI as per the existing guidelines. Everything, just like we open a bank account, we try to take the residential proof, ID proof, photograph about that person. It should not happen that Mr. X comes and open an account in the name of a fake name of Y and undertakes fraudulent transactions. So there is no Y. Y is a fake name. There should be certain guidelines required for what? To get the intermediaries registered with SEBI. Okay. Now, who are the important intermediaries? We will discuss one by one. First of all, merchant banker. What is the job of a merchant banker? Merchant banker is the most important intermediary in any public issue. Rather, the key person, merchant banker, sometimes they are called managers to the issue. You may have two managers to the issue after dividing the responsibility and roles. No issue, no problem. The functions can be divided, the functions of the merchant banker take place at the two stages of issue, pre-issue and post-issue. When whatever activities we do, till the issue is advertised in the newspaper, 21 days before, 18 to 21 days before the date, we advertise in the newspaper, that is mandatory. Before that, we must prepare the prospectus. The prospectus outline everything, the strength, weakness of the company, risk factors, price of the share. If the prospectus is a red herring prospectus, it will not disclose the price of the share, because we give a basic minimum price and people are free to bid above the price. But when the price is quoted by the process of book building, what is book building? We have discussed that before issuance of a share, we throw the bids. There are professional book builders. They will assess the market. They will assess the company. They will assess the projects undertaken by the company or the objectives of the company and try to bid, give a price. So many book builders are there. No, the other book builder does not know that another book builder is there. That is a confidential matter. After getting the bids, we decide that what can be the price. Just like that, suppose you want to sell your house. Fine. Now you will advertise in the newspaper. I want to sell my house having 3 bedrooms, 1 drawing room. Before my house, there is a lawn of 400 square feet. Backyard is 200 square feet, this, etc., etc. Constructed in the year 1999, before 20 years or 21 years. Please offer your proposals, quoting the price. Blind quote. Now they will come out in the square feet, 2000 square feet or 2500 square feet, whatever it is. You will get different bids. You will now able to assess what is your price. Suppose you have spent 30 lakhs at that time. Now, after appreciation, depreciation, everything, it comes to be 60 lakhs. You get bids more than 60 lakhs. Fine, the highest bidder. Then you can assess that what should be the value of the house. So far as valuation and revaluation are concerned, I'm going to be a little bit away from this. Remember one thing. Whenever a valuer comes to value the property, it value the intrinsic value of that particular house. What is the cost in the at that time? Suppose he asked me, sir, what is the money you have spent at that time? Like 30 lakhs I have spent. When the bag of cement was 100 rupees, now it is 350 or 400 rupees, who knows? Then appreciation of the land, depreciation of the house, he will calculate, and the cost factor he will tell me that, sir, today the cost will be this much. Market price, he will also take into account the present market value of the land as well as the house and decide upon a value. Generally, the valuation is always from the conservative side. So far as whenever you want to take a loan from the bank, always the valuation is from a conservative side. Once the value is a flop, I mean higher side, bank will be loser. That what has happened in the United States of America, I mean 12 or 13 years back, mortgage loan, higher valuation was there, more loan was given. So when the bank tries to sell the house, they get less and less. So that is a loss. So valuation, fine. So now that the share price is now almost come to a picture that this much of value is appropriate. Pre-issue, there are several activities are to be undertaken by the merchant banker. Pre-issue includes compliances with the mandatory requirements of SEBI and other regulatory authorities like Indian Companies Act. Completion of formalities according to the guidelines of issuance of share. When it is completed, listing with the stock exchange. The merchant banker, the banker to the issue is also responsible for the appointment of various other agencies involved in the issuance of share, like banker to the issue, brokers, sub brokers, etc., etc. Pre-issue, first, prospectus, vetting of prospectus by SEBI, submitting 25 copies of the prospectus to SEBI for various kind of scrutiny, then finding out the price of the share through book building process. If it is red herring prospectus, then that is a different issue altogether. Then printing of the prospectus. After approval from the SEBI, you have to disclose on which date the issue will be opened and on which date the issue will be closed in the advertisement. Pre-issue. Once it is advertised, process of issue starts. Okay, then bankers to the issue, they collect money through the applications. Brokers also collect the money. Pre-issue, at the time of pre-issue, the merchant banker also advises the organizer or management to conduct various meetings. That issue IPO must be approved in the extraordinary general body meeting of the company. It must be passed first by the board of directors. Then they will organize investors meeting in big cities. Top class investors are invited to have a feedback. That is an advertisement, you can say, for selling of their shares. Pre-issue activities. Then issue activities. Advertisement, collection of money, collection of applications formed by the brokers and sub-brokers, depositing the money in a separate account called escrow account. It is escrow account means it is not his own money, but the money received from the shareholders through the application. Every day reporting will be there, how many shares are sold till the issue closes. Once the issue closes, the money is transferred to a separate account, share application account, as you have discussed in your accounting or legal aspects of banking. Yes, or corporate law, whatever you say. Then post-issue activities. Post issue activities include management of escrow account, I told you, determining the final price at which the shares will be issued, that is, we have discussed, allotting shares to all participants as per their application basis of allotment. It is very important, BOA. After the allotment of shares is complete, basis of allotment or BOA is also advertised in the newspaper. Suppose you are to issue 1,000 shares, 1 lakh people have applied, 1 lakh share applications you have received, share which. I have applied 100 shares, fine, no issue. Then they will decide proportionate allotment. After taking into account one important factor, that they must retain small investor to the tune of 10% minimum. Who are these small investors? Those who have applied up to 1,000 shares are termed as small investors. Then after the shares applications are received, money is collected, then the shares are allotted. Final allotment is made, allotment letters are issued. Then after allotment letters are issued, then we issue the share certificate. After share certificates are issued, then the other post issue of shares activity is refund of the excess amount you have received. Suppose you have not allotted shares, the portion of non-allotment of shares to be refunded to the applicants, known as in the process of refund orders. Friends, at the time of issuance of prospectus, in the application form is also vetted by the SEBI. Standard application form is there. In the application form, so many things are there. Your risk factors are there, issue closest date is there, basis of allotment, hint is there, and your address is there, account number you are supposed to mention, so that your refund orders will come to that particular account. Now that the era of dematerialization is going on, demat of shares, that is physical scripts or physical certificates are not issued, then what is issued? Electronic certificate is issued. These electronic certificates are again sent to the allottees through their demat account. Those who are having, that is compulsory. Once you apply share means you must have demat account, you must give your demat account number. Then these share scripts are managed by your depositories, NSDL or CDSL, which we have discussed day before yesterday. These are the activities of your merchant bank. The merchant banker also ensures that another intermediary, important intermediary, is registered to the issue. The registered is actually a statutory position so far as IPO is concerned. It is not necessary that the register should be from the company issuing the shares. Register may not be an individual, may be provided to you by another company. The registrars are responsible to finalize the basis of the allotment. The most important job undertaken by the registrar is to ensure that on what basis the allotment has been made, there should not be any partiality in allotment of shares. I found that I am the promoter, my son, my daughter or my wife has applied for shares, I will ensure that they get the full benefit out of that. No. That is why registrar job to ensure that the interest of the stakeholders or shareholders must not be jeopardized at any point of time. They create a final list of applications that are valid and eligible. Applications are scrutinized by the brokers. Registrar will supervise that. Applications are scrutinized, they are in order, then basics of allotment is finalized and shares are allotted. They ensure that demat accounts of the application are credited with the allotted shares. Demat account, remember one thing, the demat account and our savings bond account, which is our current account, two different things. It is called an account. Demat account, credit balance means shares. Your demat account is credited with shares, not with money. Your refund order will come to your savings account or current account, that number you have given. So register will ensure that the demat accounts provided by the applicants, share applicants, are credited with the demat share certificates. That is the job of the thing. Sometimes merchant banker, if the base of allotment is huge, then one or two lead managers are also appointed to supervise the activities. They coordinate with the registrar and merchant banker. Their job is to coordinate various activities. Next, as you have discussed, banker to the issue, most important. Not necessarily one banker is the banker to the issue. You may engage, or the merchant banker may engage 4 to 5 banks. Remember one thing, sometimes a bank is also a merchant banker. For example, ICICI. And any bank which undertakes the merchant banking activity, also State Bank of India, Punjab National Bank, they have their own subsidiaries to look after these things. They will definitely keep themselves as one of the bankers, because why these bankers are interested to be bankers to the issue? Why? First of all, they get a small percentage as commission, whatever money they will collect. Secondly, that money will remain with them as deposit without any interest for a very long time. Almost 6 months to 1 year. So that is the advantage. Two, that boost, that money boost their liquidity position. Banker to the issuer, financial intermediaries, as we have discussed, mostly the banks who are responsible for banking related activities of the IPO. Then what exactly the activities? As I have told you, they collect the money. Acceptance of applications are collected, scrutinized by the brokers and sub-brokers, and they deposit their money with the banker. They cannot deposit with the money in any bank they like. No. These bankers to the issue, the amount should come to the bankers to the issue. Any banker. Transfer of funds to the promoters of the company after the issue closes, all the money will be transferred to the promoter after completion of everything. Then refund orders. They are to issue refund orders or transfer money, those who have not been allotted, to their respective accounts. And when the shares are issued, they remain the bankers to the issue, they continue to be the banker to the issue. Sometimes also they are engaged to pay the dividend scripts also. Refund orders and dividend payment of dividend is the end. That is that may not be applicable to the issue management, though that is an activity performed by the banker to the issue at a later stage. Now, in the IPO process, the bankers, what role, the most important role is played? That the money received by them from through the applications is accounted for, audited, and the money transferred to the promoters, they will give an account. I left one thing to tell you, that is after the issue is completed, the merchant banker is under obligation to send reports. Two reports are sent to the SEBI. That is your control reports. One report is sent after 3 days, the other report is sent after 78 days. What they mention, the activities within 3 days, what are the activities you have completed? In 78th day, what are the activities you have completed? Otherwise, SEBI will penalize you if you have not completed the activities within 78 days from the date of closure of the issue. Then comes, you have heard the term underwriters. What is an underwriter? I have told you that underwriter undertakes that this much of shares will be issued through me. He will get a commission out of that. Up to the cap is 2.5%. And if he fails to mobilize that percentage of shares out of the total shares issued, then he has to purchase himself. He has to pay the money and subscribe. Underwriters earn by taking underwriting fees from the issuers by selling the underwritten shares at a profit. Again, if they purchase the shares, sometimes what they do, they themselves subscribe the shares. So that at a later stage, when they feel that the value of the share will increase, they purchase the shares. Because they have undertaken, no? So they can sell it at a later date with a profit. Again, underwriters are banking companies. Remember one thing here, banks may act in any way they like, whatever intermediaries we are discussing, except non-banking finance companies cannot act as merchant banker. They are forbidden. Then grading agencies, I told you merchant bankers will engage several people to do several activities. Grading agency or credit rating agencies, we will be discussing separately. They also grade the IPO. What is the standard of the issue? They will give their opinion, and that is also advertised. As you might have observed, various banks advertise their mutual funds, AAA by CRISIL or B++ by ICRA, Fitch. These are all credit rating, Moody. These are all credit rating agencies. There even multinational companies are there, and some Indian companies are there, which is promoted by few major banks like State Bank of India, Punjab National Bank, Canara Bank, Bank of Baroda, etc., etc. Then this IPO grading agency, SEBI, has mandated all IPOs to be graded. It is mandatory. Once the company decides to go for public issue, then it must be graded by a rating agency. Depending on the grading, then they will ensure that the grading is genuine. ISI mark, we see ISI mark, or some another food product, what is that? FFSI or FSI mark. That is grading, that is approved by one agency which accepts the product or brand the product that it is a quality product. Quality of the issue is just by the credit rating agency that is graded. Okay, fine. Now, let us, in short, let us discuss one thing. How this IPO starts its journey, initial public offer, the life cycle of an IPO, we can say. First, the issuer company or the parent company, which issues the shares, initializes the process of IPO process by appointing lead managers or merchant banker, managers to the issue, register of the issue, then members, syndicate members. Syndicating means they are supervising the total activities. We have discussed that. Co-lead managers, co-managers to the issue, several things are there. Then the draft proposal of issuance of IPO is scrutinized by SEBI. Then you will give a draft prospectus that will be scrutinized by SEBI. After SEBI approves the draft proposal, you will submit the final advertisement or draft proposal or prospectus, 25 copies to the SEBI. Then the lead activity of lead manager starts. Lead manager submits the prospectus to the stock exchange. For what? What is the role of stock exchange now? We have discussed that stock exchange mostly handles the secondary market, not the primary market. But still, this is intimated to the stock exchange because at the end of the day, after the issue is over, these shares will be listed in those stock exchanges. That is why the stock exchanges are intimated. Before the issue, the lead manager prepares a draft of a prospectus for the IPO. That is the duty of the lead manager with the consent of the issuance company, because he gets the fees out of that. We are discussing fee-based services. Lead manager gets a fee and submit with SEBI. It also conducts advertisement or marketing of the shares. Then SEBI reviews the draft. Once the draft is ready, then the issue is open. The lead manager then submitted the offer prospectus to the stock exchange, register of issues to get it approved. As I told you, register is a statutory body or statutory position. Everything must pass through him, otherwise it will be null and void. Then date and price are decided. Printing is done, advertising is made. Here, one thing. Sometimes the company or the lead managers or the merchant bankers hire the publicity agencies to market their IPO. Now, this is the age of advertisement only. Suppose our university has got several courses. Unless the people know how many courses are offered by this university, what is the fees, what is the tenure, what is studied in that particular course, if people do not know, how you will expect that people will apply for the admission? So, just like that only, we have advertised in the newspaper. Okay, that is a marketing of things must be done. Here the marketing of IPO is done. How? First of all, they will try to highlight the, positive aspects of the company, strength of the company. Also, you have to explain the weakness of the company. These are the risk factors. Then again, at what time the advertisement should come? At what time the advertise should come? If you advertise in the dull session, then you are not going to get a better response. Generally, you will find the issues are open mostly in the month of October, November, December, January, February, up to this peak period. Fine. Again, in which paper, which language are to be issued, there must be in regional language also, in leading dailies of English paper also. Again, one thing, that is, unless and until it takes into account the regional factors, your issue will be a failure also. Certain companies are having high reputation in certain localities or sectors or regions. You change. If Hero Honda is a popular motorcycle in Odisha, come to Tamil Nadu or Telangana, here Bullet is having major market share. Go to Chandigarh, some other products are in better market. These are all regional based, so you have to take into account so many things before while advertising or marketing your shares. Now, after applications are received, complied with, then the registrar of issue receives the application and funds, check the completeness, and basis of allotment is verified, then it is advertised in the newspaper, ensures that the demat account of the applicants are credited. Once it is over, then the shares are listed in the stock exchange for further market operations, that is whether the value of the share will increase or decrease depending on the various market forces. You will know better after the shares are listed. You can see daily. Now what is the scenario? Share prices are falling in certain of certain companies, share prices are going off in certain companies. So unless and until you list your share in the stock exchange, your shares cannot be traded in the secondary market. Of course, it is mandatory. Any public company issuing the shares or private company issuing the shares scheduled through the scheduled process, then their shares are bound to be listed. So friends, this is all about the issue management. While the information provided to the investor may not be that important, in IPO, all the pertinent information must be provided. And all the information that provided to the investors must be passed and vetted by SEBI. SEBI will analyze or due diligence is made. What is due diligence? Verification of facts and figures presented before you. Whatever you are telling me, oh, my company has earned 28% profit last year. I paid dividend to the tune of 56%. Hey, give me the papers. I will verify the papers. I will then only I will take a decision. I will vet whatever you have mentioned is true or false. This is what is done mostly in the IPO. SEBI is the guardian or scanner. Without SEBI, no issue can be issued. Fine. Coming back to the next slide, where we were, Kirot. Yes, marketing the issue. Previous slide, Kirot. Pre-issue, post-issue, issue management and SEBI, public issue management. Public issue management, we have discussed the pre-issue activities, memorandum of understanding, that what memorandum of understanding between whom? The company and the merchant banker, they will agreed through a memorandum of understanding where the roles and responsibilities of the company and the roles, obligations and responsibilities of the merchant banker will be clearly spelled out. Also, the merchant banker, the intermediaries we have discussed are appointed or engaged by the merchant banker. Again, they will be entering into different MOU. MOU is a must so that afterwards, I cannot say that this is not my responsibility. So I should not be held liable or I should not be held responsible. No, it must be spelled out clearly. Then what is that? Your obtaining appraisal note. Okay. Memorandum of understanding once executed, then the merchant or banker generally put up one appraisal note about everything, which must be vetted by the company through the board meeting by the board of directors. This appraisal note and the process can be put up in the extraordinary general body meeting of the shareholders before the public issue. Then your interallocation of responsibilities, I told you, the clearly spelled out the responsibilities, rights, duties, everything should be clearly spelled out. Preparing prospectus, prospectus should be approved, submission of draft and other documents, launching of a public issue. That is pre-issue we have discussed. Post-issue we have discussed. There is basis of allotment we have discussed. Then dispatch of share certificates to the demat account in the electronic form we have discussed. Then issue of advertisement in newspaper for what? Should not be confused. Post-issue, here advertisement in the newspaper has come for issuance of shares. Post-issue activities is issuance of advertising in the newspaper about what? Closure of the issue. Issue closed. On such and such date, basis of allotment is this. So that people will know that this is the basis of allotment. Now they will calculate, I have applied for 1,000 shares. If they have, they are telling that they have, those who have applied for 1,000 shares, they have been allotted 500 shares. Those who have applied more than 1,000 shares, they have been allotted 25% of their application. Whatever it is, whatever the basis, I'm just the example only. So that will be in the newspaper only, so that there should not be any hanky-panky business in allotment of shares. No insider trading should be there. Insider trading means you are working in the company, so you take advantage of this thing, or you get yourself allotted many shares, or you are working in the issue department, you get allotted more shares in the name of your wife, daughter, brother, whatever it is. Okay, that should be prohibited and prohibited by the various guidelines enacted by Securities and Exchange Board of India, SEBI. Next slide, please, Kirut. Then marketing, we have discussed the marketing, that rigor, aggressive marketing should be there by different, people or professionals to highlight the various factors of your issue, various factors of your company, various advantages that you will gain by acquiring the shares of that company. Just preview, marketing of the issue, necess- aggressive campaigning, packaging. Packaging means what? That means here there is nothing, a bottle or a thing is not packed. Nah? The whole advertisement content is known as a package. In a package, we are giving to the public through the advertisement. Then launching your brokers and investors conference, we have discussed timing of the issue. As I told you, timing is most important. Never, now suppose pandemic situation, now people are scared, they're psychologically affected. Some people like me under quarantine also. So now if you tell me that, sir, shares have been issued, please purchase, I'll be irritated. Naturally, people are now in a different atmosphere altogether. Still, one or two companies have advertised, have found, one yesterday or day before yesterday. But that should not be. Probably they have already planned earlier, maybe. But this is not a right time. People do not bother to ensure or earn money. They are not inclined to do that because the scene is different. The scenario is different totally. Okay. So timing of the advertisement is most important. Next slide, please, Kirut. Yes, pricing. I have left one thing, this pricing factor. Pricing of what? Pricing of shares. Pricing of shares take into consideration two aspects, that is qualitative factors and quantitative factors. Qualitative factors, as I told you, that is the strength of the company issuing the shares. If you are going to issue your share at a premium, just for the sake of issuing the shares at a premium, people start issuing the premium, it will be undersubscribed totally. But if you are a very good company, reputation is very good, the your rating is very good, and if you just throw away without premium at par, if you issue, you are issuing the shares, then what will happen? Oversubscribed will be there. In both the cases, these are not good symptoms. You should ensure oversubscribed is good, but to such a limited extent. Undersubscription is not at all acceptable. Should not be. That once it is undersubscribed means somewhere there is a flaw. So qualitative aspect means the positive or strength of that particular issuer company. Everything. All are qualitative factors. Which engages the merchant banker? Which company is given in charge of bankers to the issue? Who are the brokers? Who are the sub-brokers? These are all matter in pricing also. So qualitative factors are positive factors of the issuer's company. Mostly quantitative factors, coming back to the quantitative factors, so many things are taken into account. Your return of investment, your project, what project you have undertaken. What is the expected dividend? Peers group, your peers, your competitors are same in the industry. Suppose you are advertised, or this public issue is for MRF tires. Now, if MRF tires is advertised, when pricing the shares, people will compare, or MRF, the investors, potential investors will compare the dividend ratio or earning per share ratio of other tire manufacturing company like Seat, Bridgestone, Apollo, etc., etc. Fine. So these are quantitative factors. Before pricing, two important factors, qualitative factors, which cannot be measured only, it cannot be measured. Quantitative factors, which can be measured, so far as pricing of the shares is concerned. These two factors are also considered by the book builders, whom we have entrusted the job of finding out what should be the price of our share we are going to issue. Thank you. Next slide. Book building, we have discussed nothing. They give us various bids. If they would have purchased the shares of our company, what price they would have paid? That is the consideration. And their professionals, look, one thing, after the bids are received, if the price is fixed, suppose the average is taken into account. Suppose somebody has given your price will be 100 plus a premium of 20 rupees. Somebody has given your 100 plus premium is 75 rupees. Somebody has given 100 plus premium 50 rupees, like that. Having considered everything, we find out one price. And they are giving the reasons and explanations, not that just quoting. Okay, you can issue at 125. No, they will give reasons. So many reasons they used to give. They actually research, investigate into the matter to a lot, because they are also paid commission. We are discussing fee-based service. Nothing is free here. Everything is payable. Everything has to be paid. So this book building process, we want to fix the price of the share. Book builders are professionals. Even some bankers, private bankers are looking at book builders are there. Professional book builders are there. Okay, thank you, to judge the price. Next slide, please. Next slide. Debt instrument. Whether it is equity instrument or debt instrument, the policy or principles of issuance of share or IPO mostly the same. In debt instrument, it is not ownership. Equity shares are equity instruments. Preference shares, equity instruments, debentures, bonds, these are all debt instruments. No, they are not the owners. Process of issuance of debt instrument, process of issuance of equity instruments follow the same path, same, mostly little differences there. Thank you. Next slide. Kirot. Yes. Next come the corporate advisory services. Up to now, we discussed various factors regarding issue of shares, issue management, beginning to end, journey of the IPO, first job to last job, first job decision in the board meeting, last job listing of shares in the stock exchange. Over almost 10 to 12 activities are there in between. We have discussed, mostly we have covered. Corporate advisory service unit 2, that what are the services, professional services, as my colleague has told KC Maharana, that corporate to corporate, services offered by the corporates, services rendered by the corporates, services accepted by the corporates mostly, though the individual investors are indirectly there. What are the various services offered for a fee, or what are the advices, services which we advise? I will advise you. Do you know, yesterday I talked to someone here. He has prepared one CV, curriculum vitae. You know, we are acquainted with what a CV is. Can you imagine if you give it to a professional CV maker, what is the charge? The charge ranges from 5,000 to 50,000 rupees just for a CV, 2 pages. Imagine the professionalism. That is why I told you nothing. There is nothing called a free lunch. Anything that you do, talk, and say in corporate jungle, you can say that is payable or paid for. You have to pay for it. Here, anything, any consultancy you require or any advice you require, they provide for a fee. What are the various advisory services? One by one, we will discuss. What is that? First, making of public issue and issue management, we have discussed right now. Process of counseling and pre-investment studies. That is, before issuance of share, you engage one consultant to ensure if we are going for any IPO right now, is it the right time? Should we go or should we not go? Then your corporate restructuring. Okay, corporate restructuring. Restructuring means what? We are changing something. Restructuring of our drawing room means we will take out the sofa facing, already it was facing towards east, now we will face towards west, or we will remove two chairs or add two chairs, like that, restructuring. We restructure something. Then this restructuring is, friends, what we are restructuring? Corporate restructuring means several things are there under corporate restructuring. First, organizational restructure. This whole organizational structure, span of management or span of control, we say almost 10 years, 7 years back, Boston Consultancy Group, BCG, was engaged by a bank, a nationalized bank, to restructure the organizational structure. Earlier, what was the organizational structure earlier? Branch. The branch manager is the head of the branch. Branch used to report to regional office. Under the regional office, say 100 or 200 branches are there. Regional office used to report zonal office. Under the zone, there are 5 to 6 regions. Regions are headed by regional managers. Zones are headed by zonal managers. Then zonal offices will report to the head office. How many structures are there? Branch, regional office, zonal office, head office. Four-tier structure was there. Boston Study Group advised the bank that abolish the zonal structure. Regional offices will be renamed. The nomenclature of regional office will be changed to zonal office. Same regional office will be there, but a higher position will be coming. Termed as zonal office, they will be reporting directly to the head office. Thereby, how many thousands of crores rupees can be saved? They gave an opinion. They take huge fees. Again, one bank engaged Boston Consultancy Group, I think BCG, yes. That the company says that, well, again, a bank. You see, people are not attached. Sense of belonging is not there. At least at the lower level, I mean the clerical stage or peon stage, they don't have any sense of belonging. They just work for money. A sense of belonging should be developed. Okay, fine. They engaged another training group. They started imparting training of 2 days to one and all. Starting from the sweep, the peon to the general manager. So, again, by paying a fees. So, services unique. You can create service and sell it to the corporate. That is corporate structure. Again, CDR, corporate debt structuring. Corporate debt structuring is what? CDR mechanism. Total debt will be restructured. Suppose you are a borrower. You have taken a loan from me. I'm giving a small example. Corporate level, I'm not giving an example. I'm giving a small example for individual basis. Then if we combine together, it will be corporate basis. And you are a company. You have taken a loan from the bank. The repayment schedule says that 2 years gestation period will be there. Gestation period means what? That is repayment holidays, you can say. Two years you did not pay the installment. Because how can you pay? Because your project will be commencing after 2 years now. You will gain your operating profit will come after 2 years. So how can you pay before 2 years? Now, the thing is that you will be paying after 2 years installments, but interest will be accumulated, interest will be added to the principal, and the installments will be fixed. he fails to pay after 2 years and approach that, sir, because this corona is going on, pandemic situation, labor is not available, my work is blocked, so I cannot pay. In this period, you give me at least another 1 year or 2 year, whatever it is, then the whole debt is restructured. That means after 4 years, he'll be paying interest during this period, will be paid after 4 years also, or he will be paying this much to right now and the rest of the amount, any combination. This is known as debt restructuring. Organizational restructuring, I gave you an example. This is debt restructuring. It may be also capital restructuring. It may be debt equity restructuring, that what is should be the ratio of debt to equity, what should be the capital so that we can take, how much of loan we can take so that sustain. So any change proposed for a profit or a gain and given advice taken or given, if we are providing the advice, we are getting the fees. We are specialized in providing the advice. Sometimes we have to take advice from other professionals. We are paying a fees. This is about your capital or structuring or restructuring, whatever it is. Capital restructuring means what? What should be the equity shares? What should be the preference share? Whether it should be debt instruments or equity instruments, how the capital should be restructured. That's all. Whether we go for public issue or we should not go for public issue. Should we increase the capital base or should we not increase the capital base? Should we go for issuance of equity shares at a premium or at a discount or at a par? Or should we go for issuance of bonds or debentures? These are all, these things are related to your capital restructuring. Anything, if you take the advice from any professionals, or here we will talk from the corporate side, that corporates are their companies are there providing this advice for a fees. Next, your loan syndication. Yes, loan syndication. It is also known as consortium. In the banking terminology, it is known as consortium finance or consortium advance. Consortium means what? If generally a branch receives a proposal, powers are vested from different cadre to cadre. But irrespective of the power, the general guideline is that if you are receiving a proposal more than 100 crores, particularly earlier, now probably it is over 500 crores also. Depending on the company, depending on the product, depending on the background of the promoters, depending on the goodwill of the promoters, depending on the location of the industry, several factors are considered. Then the bank takes a decision that, sir, fine, you have applied for 500 crores, but we are not going to finance you single-handedly. We will be financing your project, but in a group. We will be the group leader. So because the proposal has come to me, now I will arrange another 2 to 3 bankers. Together, we will finance that 500 crores, that is loan syndication. Now, who will take a decision? Now, any corporate house professional advising the particular corporate that you will get a loan, 500 crores, I will arrange. I will talk to 4 or 5 banks. I will arrange the bankers. Who will be the lead banker, leader of the consortium? Who will be the members of the consortium? Who will be financing what ratio? Okay, now things are managed. For arranging these bankers or for arranging the loan syndication also, I am taking a fees from you. I'm corporate, I'm professional, I'm doing the job. So I'm an expert in that. Again, I will be having my own judgment in which banks have to be selected, which bank charges what rate of interest, which bank will dispose the proposal at an earlier date, or they will be, please come tomorrow, I'm busy today, please come after 1 month, dilly-dally. Because the corporate cannot wait, time is money enough for them. So this is another service provided by the corporate for a fee-based services, corporate advisory services. This is one of the important services provided by any corporation, professional corporation. Next is your liaison with foreign collaborator making preparation of joint venture. If you are going for a joint venture operation with a foreign partner, foreign partners we seek only for technology. Okay, materials mostly available with us, labor is available with us, and capital also we can manage, but technology, for technology we used to seek the partnership or joint venture operations from the foreign, but we do not know anybody. I'm ready to start, I arrange the capital, resources, location, everything, but technology, I feel that probably I should consult USA or China or whatever it is. Okay, If I utter the name of China again, you will be irritated. No. Okay, we will go for USA, with USA. So, who will arrange? These professionals will arrange foreign collaborators, foreign partners. That is, again, they will charge a fees for that. Okay. They will take their due diligence, they verify their credentials, everything. That is their headache, not our headache. Next, raising foreign currency loan, euro issues, foreign currency loans, FCCB is there. Okay, if you want to import certain things, foreign currency loan is required, then that is another aspect. Foreign currency loan also you can arrange. Now foreign currency loan can be provided by Indian banks also to a limited extent. Next, merger and acquisition. Suppose your company wants to acquire another company. Suppose MRF Tires wants to acquire the Apollo Tires as subsidiary. Or Maruti Suzuki wants to acquire MRF Tires, whatever it is. Once that company is taken over, it will function as a subsidiary. Their management control is finished. That is acquisition. That acquisition is a long process. Several activities have to be done. Anybody, any company offering that I will be doing all these things for you, sir, for this fees, then quotations will be received from different corporate activities. That what is the rate you quote, KC Maharana sir tell that I will sir, take 0.5%. Then Devasis Babu will say, no, it is very less. I will take 0.60. So these are the things I will finalize. Who will do the job? I will pay the fees. They will do the activities. Then your merger. In merger, the total sublimation is there. The merged companies will be losing their identities. One recent example I can quote with effect from 1st April 2020, Oriental Bank of Commerce lost its identity. United Bank of India lost its identity. Now, all the branches of United Bank of India and Oriental Bank of Commerce will be known as Punjab National Bank because both the banks have been merged with Punjab National Bank. Merger. Merger and acquisition, not a small step. 1 year before, I think January 19, this announcement was made. Preparation started from 1st January 1919, probably, most probably. And it is yet to be completed. Only the balance sheet are yet to be merged. Though the nomenclature has changed. So you just see, and it has been given, the responsibility is given to a corporate body. They are taking hundreds of crores for doing all these activities. They are directing how to do, what to do, everything. Okay. Now, consultancy for rehabilitation of Sikh industrial units. Earlier, BIFR was there, Board of Industrial Reconstructions. That BIFR was, once a company fails to repay the debt, then the regions are analyzed, whether it is Malia, whether it is Nirav Modi, or whether it is Ambani or anybody else. If no fraudulent intention was there, he started his company in 2019, 2020, pandemic starts, sales reduced. I was looking the share price of one tire company yesterday. The price of the share value was 1,370. In January 2019, and the yesterday price was 870 rupees, 50, and crashed like anything. So naturally he will be defaulted, he will default in repayment. For two things people default, either their products affected in the market, sale is not there, or they need more fund to expand the project on time. If they don't get the funds, their production is hampered, so they need further finance. It happens on two reasons. First, when you prepare the project, you have taken the value of the current debt. Suppose, another example, the government of Karnataka wanted to construct one guest house in Tirupati. The earlier government, previous, now the BJP government is there. When the other party of Gowda was there, at that time the estimate of 100 bedded guest house was 20 crores. Now they make it to 500 bedded 200 crores. Price cost escalation will be there. When the cost escalation is there in a company or corporate body, unless you finance them, further inject money to them, they will be dead. If you don't give medicines to a patient, he will die. That is rehabilitation. When you rehabilitate a company by providing support, further support, that is rehabilitation. And consultancy, these corporate bodies are there who are acting as consultant for rehabilitation of the sick industrial units. They charge a fee, that is known as rehabilitation activities. Next is your, there is other corporate advisory activities are there. Before discussing credit rating, other various corporate activities are there, we can say, starting from formation of a company, formation of limited liability partnership, e-filing of various returns, tax return, annual return, maintenance of compliance, merger acquisition, just now we discussed corporate restructuring, consultancy on various issues, preparing the memorandum of association, preparing the prospectus, arranging for your issue of fresh issue, arranging bankers to the issue, arranging register to the issue. All the activities come under the corporate advisory services generally. You tell me any service, anything for which a particular corporate is not there, anything. Suppose I want to take a loan from a bank. I do not know how to prepare a project report. Just I will contact someone. They will ask me, sir, only project report I will prepare, or I will arrange the banker for you. I will say, fine, you arrange a banker. I don't need to search. They will do everything for me. And the charge is sometimes ranging from 2% to 5% of the total project cost. If my project cost is 1 crore, he will be charging 5 lakhs for doing all these things. Everything. Starting from project report, loan documentation, arranging the bank. I will just go to sign the papers. That's all. And I will get the money. So these are all the services provided. One important thing is here, valuation, search reports, legal compliance, due diligence services, everything is done by corporate bodies for a fee. And these are known as corporate advisory services. Coming back to credit rating in India. Or credit rating, what is credit rating? First of all, this concept of credit rating came into existence mostly after the liberalization or globalization, we can say, initial period of 90s, we can say. Several credit rating agencies come. Look one thing. These chartered accountants firms and these rating agencies, if they only work for the borrower because they take the fees from the borrower, that is a dangerous phenomenon. These two professionals must act unbiased. Otherwise, their goodwill will be at stake at the later stage. So, credit rating agencies are multinational companies are there, Indian companies are there. So many rating agencies are there, to name a few. Famous, Crisil, one, ICRA, Fitch, Smera. These are all credit rating agencies. What they do? They will rate you as in the high. While taking the CLC, the headmaster or headmistress write, he bears a good moral character. Character, very good. Okay. But if you are doing mischiefs in the school or college, then you will not get a good character certificate. Gone. Your career is gone. Whenever a company, whether at the time of issuing of shares, mostly, they used to rate. What is the rating of the two things are rated? The company can be rated, the issue can be rated, the mutual fund can be rated, or the debt can be rated also, the shares can be rated also. So many things are taken into account and rating is done. Oh, that company, what is that rating? Navratna companies. Do you think just in the fine morning somebody was sleeping and in the early morning declared that these companies are Navratna companies? No, they are rated Very good. So this rating agency's job is to rate it. Just like we evaluate the answer scripts, award the grades, A grade, B grade, C grade, D grade, whatever the grade or marks. Like that, they grade the corporation. Then what are the details of what are the benefits of the rating? If we talk about rating, it is awarding some type of reputation in what? What is the meaning actually of credit rating and why should one go for the credit rating? Credit rating is an assessment of borrower. If a company wants to get a loan, he is a potential borrower, that company must be rated. If an individual wants a loan from a big shot or high value customer, then that particular venture should be rated. The project must be rated. To determine whether the borrower with the ability to pay back, whether the project given to you is able to earn profit in future, whether it is technically feasible or financially viable to earn sufficient revenue so that your loan, what you are going to give after this, will be coming back to you. Otherwise, it will be a bad loan. Okay, the Pricewater Group, what happened? Satyam, in Satyam case, Matisse was formed. The reverse of Satyam is Matisse. Mr. Raju. Then they prepared fact balance sheet to show their assets overvaluing. And Pricewater Group was the chartered accountant. Gone. Reputation is gone forever. That happens. If you rate or give a wrong rating, then you are gone. Fine. You will earn some money temporarily. But as a MNC, as a famous chartered accountant firm, what is your reputation? It is nowhere. It stands nowhere. Like that, rating is important from that point of view. The importance of rating is that lender mostly depends on that rating. The borrower also get benefited by that rating because no one is, nowadays the time is gone. Earlier, what we used to do? Mr. K.C. Mahana or Mr. Devasis or XYZ has applied for a loan. Okay, fine. Achha. But then I will ask some people, what type of man Mr. Maharana is? I will go to his locality or I will ask somebody nearby his shop or nearby his company, what type of man is? Aadmi to badhiya hai sir, bahut acha aadmi hai. Phir main pucha ki bhai X kaisa hai? Kya kyun sir? Aadmi to theek nahi hai wo. Wo to Andhra Bank se kuch paisa liya tha makan banane ke liye, diya nahi paisa. Reputation. Rating is an independent reputation of yours placed with facts and figures in black and white before you, based on which you can take a credit decision which will not go wrong in future. Because as a banker, I am playing with what? Public trust. This is not my money, na? This is the money deposited by public. It is a trust. I cannot play with that money. I must take independent and prudent decisions before financing a borrower. I depend on the ratings given by various agencies to the borrower. Where the safety is assured, better investment decision I can take, and my funds is safe in the hands of the borrowers, which I will get back. Now you can question me that, sir, so many rating is done, still so many loans are going bad. Vijay Malia is there, Nirav Modi fled away. You see, that is a connivance of the rating agency, that is a connivance of the borrower, the connivance of the banker. So many people are involved. You see good and bad people everywhere. So if you bad people manage to commit a fraud, then what can we do? We're helpless. But ultimately, the hand of law, jo kanun ka haath bahut lamba hota hai. Now what they got actually? He might be, what he was, now what he is. He just taking asylum in a country like a thief. Then what happened? Okay, fine, he has enjoyed. Now I don't have to think, suppose I'm very poor, but I've got freedom. Nobody can cast aspersion or point out a finger that look, he's what he was hooted when he went to see a cricket match or something like that. He was hooted in the public by Indians there. So that is the reputation. This happens. Okay. This is about the financer. For borrowers, the borrowers need not have to go time and again. कहते हैं ना bank alone, आपका जूता घिस जाएगा क्योंकि तुरंत उन लोग लोन नहीं देते हैं। व्हाई दे डू नॉट गिव, तुरंत क्यों नहीं देते हैं? लोग कहते हैं जैसे उसका अपना पैसा है, जैसे दे रहा है ना पैसा, वो अपना घर से ला के दे रहा है। यस ही शुड थिंक लाइक दैट, अदरवाइज गॉन योर मनी विल बी, द डिपोजिटर्स विल गेट ए ब्लो। सम पीपल दे डू नॉट नो हाउ टू गिव ए लोन, व्हाट डॉक्यूमेंट्स आर टू बी टेकन, दे आर वेरी स्केयर्ड, दे विल नॉट टच, एजिप्ट इज अ फायर, बोथ द थिंग्स, नॉलेज गैप इज देयर, दैट प्लेज अ रोल, और फियर फैक्टर इज देयर, और you have got certain demerits with you so that he is avoiding you. Easy loan approval is there if rating is done. First, banker gets the benefit of getting the reputation of the borrower so that his money is safe. So he takes a prudent credit decision by credit rating. Borrower gets advantages because no, he will not be harassed. And also, if your rating now is that in every loan, if your rating in corporate loan, if your rating is very good, you will get interest concession also. Your rating is A, 10%. Your rating is A plus plus, 9.5%. Your rating is 9 triple plus, 9%. Your rating is B, 11%. So you will get the benefit of rating also. Fine. Rating is done how? I approach CRISIL. Sir, I am going to take a loan. This is my project, etc. Please rate my company. They will undertake field work. They will also engage certain people to collect information about you. They will collect information about the project. They will collect the information about the peer group in the same industry. And they will give the rating. Rating is not that easy. That takes months together. They will have several meetings with you. If you are having an account or a small loan account also with your bank, they will approach the bank. What is your opinion about this man? They will take your opinion also. Other banks, suppose I have a small house building loan with State Bank of India, and now I'm applying for a big loan with PNB. Now, credit rating agency will go to State Bank of India to see what is the my transactions in the account, my behavior as a borrower. Okay, then these rating agencies will be given the report for a particular fee. So many agencies I have told you are working based on the feedback and reports. They analyze several things, your bank account, your balance sheet, your tax returns, field visit reports, opinion about the peers group, and they form the opinion. Based on the opinion, reports, facts and figures, your company or your project is rated by the rating agencies. Sir, next slide, please. Next slide, limitations of what? Yes, rating, one thing, rating, fine, 90% people depends on rating, but we cannot give a guarantee that rating cannot be biased. Rating can be biased on 2 to 3 accounts. First of all, rating agency has got vested interest, or by getting some more money, he may give a better rating than what he is. There again, he is doing a mistake. Sometimes the reports collected by the persons are misleading or wrongly placed, rating may be biased, or rating may be biased by pressures, push and pulls by people at the high position. That also happens. For example, a top level politician in the ministry, or he's a minister now, any ministry, pressurized the bank to sanction a loan in somebody's favor. The rating is not good. The bank will approach the rating agency. Sir, thoda rating achha kar dijiye. Happens. Again, these are all exceptional cases. Fine. Then downgrading also. If you have availed a loan of 100 crores and above, every year it will be rated. Once you had, while taking a loan, your grade was A or A plus plus, but after 2 years, if your grade is B, your interest rate will be increased, and you will be put several other conditions. Okay, so first of all, credit rating services started mostly late 80s and early 90s. The gradings are different for CRISIL, AAA, AA, BBB, then BCD, single letter, low grading, multiple letters, good rating. ICRA is also there. ICRA rating is also different. Fitch rating is also different. ICRA gives rating, or they rated your bank loan credit, corporate debt restructuring credit, your financial sector ratings are also there. Mutual fund can be rated, your equity public issues can be rated, your project financing can be rated, or your medium SMEs can also be rated. CARE is also there. So CRISIL, CARE, Fitch, ICRA, these are all rating agencies and give their rating in a different manners. But the criteria remains the same. Certain companies or certain credit rating agencies, they do not undertake high value companies. Sometimes the bank engages two rating agencies, and the rating process I have discussed, two rating agencies, they will get two reports. If the ratings differ significantly, they will again approach a third rater. And out of the three ratings, they will consider, the bank will consider which rate should be taken up. Fine. Your credit score, it is a small example. Now credit scores, you will get mails, na? Know your credit score. If you are paying, they know. If suppose generally they get the information from your credit cards. If you are paying credit card amount in one go every month, not delayed, on the due date you are making the payment, your credit score will be definitely higher. If you are making the payment installment wise, little bit less grading. If you have any time defaulted that installment, rating will be further low. Now you must be getting messages from different banks. Don't worry, don't pay in a single go. Flexi pay, we will structure your loan, this, that. But that will affect your credit score. Sometimes they also mention your credit score will not be affected. So many things are there. All these are marketing. And they are all doing these services to you for a fee only. Fine. So rating process, I have told you. Papers required, they see. Places required, they visit. Persons required, they meet. What are the three things? Papers, place, and persons. Three P's only. Places of interest, wherever they go, they will collect information. Papers are definitely required, and persons, important persons who are supposed to be your peers, your competitors, your friends, they will be definitely meeting and collect their opinions before giving the ratings to you. So this is the job of a credit rating agency, which is beneficial to both the financier, the financing company, the borrowing company, the borrowers, everybody. It is win-win situation for all, but should ensure the reputation of the agency as well as the genuinity of that particular rating. Next, mutual fund. Mutual fund, very simple. Mutual fund is like what? You can say. School jaate the pehle, tiffin dabba leke, tiffin box leke, hum log jaate the kahan? School jaate the. Fine. Toh, हम लोग बैठ जाते थे पांच सात दोस्त मिलके, इवन ऑफिस भी जाते थे टिफिन डब्बा लेके, तो सब खोलते हैं टिफिन डब्बा, सब खाना सब मिलके खाते थे. सो मेनी वैरायटी हो जाता था. म्यूचुअल फंड इज ऑल्सो लाइक दैट टू सम एक्सटेंट. व्हाट इज दैट? पीपल लाइक यू एंड मी, वी आर पुअर पीपल, वी डू नॉट नो द इंट्रिकेसीज ऑफ ट्रेडिंग शेयर्स इन द स्टॉक एक्सचेंज. वी डू नॉट हैव मच कैपिटल सो दैट वी कैन फ्लोट ए कंपनी. But as a middle class or lower middle class people, whatever little money we are having as savings, we want to put it in the bank. First target is, fine, 10,000 rupees fixed deposit kar do, aur 3 saal ke liye theek, 2 saal ke liye theek. Little money is there, savings mein thoda moda interest mil jayega 3.5%. Fixed mein rakh dete hain, to mil jata hai 6.5 to 7.5%, senior citizen 8% ho gaya. But, and we do not want to take the risk of purchasing shares. Oh, bhai, company doob jayega, pura itna paisa mera zero ho jayega. Theek hai bhai, 6% mil raha hai, it is enough for me, I am happy with that. I do not want to earn more. But, business ka thumb rule kya hai? What is the thumb rule of a business? More risk, more profit. Less risk, less profit. Here comes a middle way path. One expert comes. Why you are scared? Fine. I will give you more than the fixed deposit rate. Interest. Assured. He will collect money. This fellow, so everybody will collect money. So a bigger chunk of money will be there. He will invest. That agency, that middle person will invest it in different securities. Mutual fund is just a pool. Everybody will put some water in a big pool. All the people in the village are told that tomorrow we will have some puja. Everybody should bring a glass of milk and put it here. Okay. One person was very clever. People are very clever in thinking. They started thinking that if I take a glass of water, so everybody will come with milk. If I will put water, who will know that I have put in water? Everybody thought like that. And they all came with water. The pool was full of water. No milk was there. So that was also a pool. Fine. Here this pool is that you put your little money in the pool. Bigger chunk of money will be there. Sizable amount will be there. That will be invested in the stock market and earn profit on behalf of you. That gentleman who has taken the risk in collecting the money, mutual fund, the corporation who floats the mutual fund, will take a share, take his commission or take his percentage of profit and give you back to you. This mutual fund, as I told you, that first of all, again, I am very cautious. I'll ask him, bhai, fixed deposit mein to mujhe 6.5% mil jata hai. Ab bataiye, ab mujhe kitna denge? Bole ki dekhiye sir, wo mutual fund wala batayega. There are different types of mutual fund. I think the next slide will be there. Yes. So far as mutual scheme, various schemes are there. Operational classification, open-ended scheme, closed-ended scheme. Okay, what is an open-ended scheme? That is always available. Today also you go, you can invest, that mutual fund is open. Tomorrow also go, there is no last date like your IPO. Closed-ended schemes are there, that fixed date is there. On that particular date, that scheme closes. After that, you cannot invest in that. That is closed-ended scheme. Return-based classification, income funds, growth funds, and conservative funds. Income funds means what? You will get monthly interest or quarterly interest or half yearly interest continuously till the amount is invested. Growth fund is that like your fixed deposit at the maturity time. I'll put it in 3 years, I'll get the accumulated interest will be almost 12%. Say, for example, then I'll go for growth fund. Abhito, my daughter is not getting married. She is only in plus two. Final year, then it will take 5 years. So, okay, fine. I'll put the money for 5 years and at the time of my daughter's marriage, I'll get it mature. I'll get a good amount for the marriage purpose. Then, of course, if the corona prevails, expenditure will not be there in the marriage. That is a different thing. Then conservative funds. Conservative funds is a hybrid fund. Both. You will see that interest also you are earning to a lesser extent, and some portion is added to your principal amount so that at the maturity you will get. Hybrid of income and growth fund is conservative funds. Again, this investor is very clever. He asked him, "Hi, my money you are collecting, where you are investing first, tell me." No, any higher rate is given means they are investing in equity fund. Once you are contributing to the mutual fund, for equity funds you will get higher return because you are taking higher risk. I'm conservative, I will say, no, my money should not be invested in equity fund, bond fund, debt fund, it is called debt fund or bond fund, whatever it is. Then my money is not invested for equity shares, my money is invested in the bonds or debt debentures. So I'll be getting less return, but assured return. That is another kind of mutual fund. Then balanced fund or middle path. As this conservative fund is a mixture, like balanced fund is also the mixture of both equity and bond fund. Then what kind of mixture it is, it will be there. That depends on the various kinds of mutual fund. Whether 50-50, 50 equity investment will be there. If you have contributed 100 rupees, 50 rupees of yours will be invested in equity shares. 50 rupees of yours will be invested in debenture. Now, you have a right to know. There are different schemes thousands and lakhs of people are there like you and me who are having little money savings. They are contributing to the mutual fund, pulling up the fund, and depending on the scheme, it is balanced. This balanced fund is a scheme-based balance, 10 to percentage-wise, which percentage will be invested in equity, which percentage will be invested in bond, that will be taken a decision. Then sector-based classification also there, because Gujarat, all are invested-oriented. All are having shares. Maharashtra, then Maharashtra. Eastern people, no. Bank is okay. So sector-based classification, while you are marketing your schemes for various mutual funds, sector-based classification is also there. I will be interested to see that whether you are investing, in which sector you are investing, whether it is iron and steel, whether it is cotton, whether it is tires, whether it is car. Schemes are also related to equity, bond, balance, also sector of industry, which type of industry you are investing. Leverage-based classifications means what is the balance you are taking. Sector-wise balance is done, some percentage in this sector, some percent in this sector, that is leveraging your classification. Okay. Everything is a combination and classification. Return-based, investment-based, sector-based. Taking three, we can leverage it in a leverage-based classification. Then this scheme is formulated. That is why thousands of mutual fund schemes are there to allure the investor, so that whatever is best suitable to you, you can invest in that. That's all. Thank you for mutual fund. Next slide is for probably securitization of assets. Please come, Kirut. Managing mutual fund. Okay, fine. Pre-issue like IPO, marketing can be done. Post-issue, secretarial job, paperwork, investment, and accounts. After taking the money, secretarial job is over, then we put the money in the investment, and accounting aspect is coming, that is the post-issue of mutual funds. Next, portfolio management process. Portfolio management is setting investment goal of schemes, identification of specific securities, portfolio designing and revising the portfolio. This is another, I think this is given after mutual fund, I don't know. Probably it should have been at the time of your corporate advisory services. Okay, we have discussed it, Kirut. Next unit, asset securitization. First of all, read the second one. Asset securitization is a synthetic technique of converting liquid assets into liquid assets through the process of issuing securities to the investors by SPV, special purpose vehicle. This special purpose vehicle is not a car or a truck. It is an agent or a company. Sole job is for taking advantage of securitization. First of all, we should know what is securitization. I have taken a house building loan from a bank. Like me, thousands of people have taken loan from the bank. The rate of interest is, say, for example, 10%. The bank is earning 10%. And the portfolio of that particular bank, house building loan occupies a major share in the portfolio of the bank. After 2 to 3 years, two things may happen. Some sectors of the economy demand more cash or liquid from the banking sector, where the rate of interest, possible rate of interest earning is more than 10%. But now I am in a fix. My money is blocked in the housing sector. You have mortgaged your property to me and I have given you the loan. One case, I am tempted that ye agar chukta mit jata na, ye house wale, house building loan wale sab paisa mujhe deke band kar dete, to I would have invested in now this automobile sector. Automobile sector bhi chal raha hai, to I will get about 12%, 13%. My bank will be richer or my bank will earn more profit. Okay, fine. This is bank. First case. Second case, house building loan, more than 60% are defaulters. Then what will happen? The cash flow you are projecting did not match with your asset. Here I will just divert your attention to another thing, ALM. What is ALM? Assets liability management. What are the assets for a bank? Loans and advances is the important asset for a in a bank's balance sheet. Liabilities are deposits, because he has taken the money to pay back on demand. These asset liabilities should not mismatch. When it mismatches, when you go for premature payment of your fixed deposit, you have put the deposit for 5 years, 1 crore. After 1 year, you will go. That is why they deduct the penalty of 1 or 2% is charged. Okay. Now suppose you have single case, you have deposited 1 crore with me for 5 years. Mr. Maharana approached me for a loan. Devasis deposited 1 crore. Maharana sir approached me for a loan. Then I asked Maharana sir, how much you need? No sir, I will require 50 lakhs. What is the repayment? No sir, I will pay within 5 years or 4 years. Up to 5 years, okay. Because I have got Devasis Babu's 1 crore. He will be getting the money after 5 years. I will pay him 5 years with interest. Now Maharana sir is asking for a loan. Let me pay. Now what happens? Devasis Babu deposit is with me. He asked for a premature payment. I am duty bound to pay. Though I will pay less interest. Again, I will borrow somehow because I don't have, where can I go? I have already given the money to Maharana sir. After credit creation, let us not go to that part. Then where I will get the money? I will borrow from market to repay him. Then I am loser, first case. Second case, asset liability management. He has taken a loan. He did not pay me. Devasis Babu's FD is mature. How can I pay him? Again, I have to borrow. That means in both the cases, if anybody goes out of the contract between the bank and the borrower, or the bank and the depositor, asset liability mismatch will be there. In that case, bank borrows from the open market at a higher rate of interest for making the payment or honoring the commitments. Now say the second stage is defaulters. House building loans, they observe, survey that defaulted any payment. Or in any sector, I will invest, I will get more. What I will do? All the house building loans, I will collateralize all mortgage. This is known as mortgage-based security. Here, mortgage is there. Another company will come, sir, okay, I will take up all your house building loans. I will pay liquid, I will pay full amount on as on debt. Discount is this. Are you ready? Okay, fine, no issue. He will pay from my balance sheet. House building loan is gone. My money comes back. I'm now liquid rich. I can invest in some other ventures. One issue, asset management company. Here the special purpose vehicle is the agent who does this job in between the banker and the investors. What this SPV will do with that particular collateralized securities? He has already invested. Where from he will get the money? He will issue now certificates or shares of his company, based on the value of the securities of the, because he has got securities, no. So there is no problem. Car loans, I want to collateralize. Credit cards, I want to collateralize. Asset based, there are two best. Mortgage based security, where mortgage is there, security. Assets based securities, no mortgage is there, only a sort of guarantee is there. Okay, both the cases, recovery will be affected. Then what happens? Those who have taken the loan, they will repay to whom? They will not pay to the SPV, na? They will go to the bank and pay the money there. Then what is the responsibility of that banker who has collateralized or securitized the loans? He will pass on the money to the SPV, that agent who has done the job, by keeping a commission. Again, the passing of the money, there are two routes. Next slide. Two routes are there. Benefits of, first, benefits of securitization. Issuer means the banker here. Whatever you talk about, banker. Improved capital adequacy, I'll explain. See, liquidity position is improved. And he can give new loans with higher rate of interest. What is capital adequacy? Another, this is the big issue, topic, capital adequacy. Capital adequacy is that CRAR, it is known as capital ratio to risk weighted assets. Assets means loans. What is the risk weight attached to your loan vis-a-vis the capital? Suppose in a bank, the capital is 1 crore. total loan given is say 3 crores, 5 crores. And don't ask me how 1 crore deposit, 5 crores loan, that is their credit creation is possible. Now, suppose these loans are risk weighted as 100%. 100% risk is there. Certain loans are 20% risk. Fixed deposit, loan against fixed deposit, 10% risk. Staff loan, 20% risk. Credit cards, 125% risk. Several risks are fixed. Now, these risk weighted assets will be added together and calculate this and divided. Capital divided by the risk weighted assets will give you the ratio. What is the mandatory ratio you must achieve? Otherwise, you will be debarred by the RBI. The Basel-based committee prescribed that 8% should be the benchmark. More than that is good. That is what is your capital adequacy ratio. Unless you are having liquidity, then your capital adequacy ratio will not improve. Okay. Simply speaking, means suppose it is your capital adequacy 10%. Means what? 10 times you have given the loans, 10 times 100% risk weighted loans, you can give 10 times 1 crore. That means you can go up to 10 crores of financing of 100% risk. If the risk weighted is reduced, then more loans can be given. So that ratio will be 8% or 10%, whatever it is. Okay, fine. Investors, good liquidity, safety, increased yield, diversification. Who are the investors? To whom this collateralized SPV sells the shares? I am investor, I purchase the share of the SPV. SPV is not scared because he is getting the money. If he will not get, he will sell the securities because he has got a right over the properties mortgaged to the bank. He'll ask the bank, now you sell these securities. They are not paying. Bank will decide whose asset will be sold. That money will be passed on to the SPV. So the investors will be paid their interest or dividend, whatever it is. If it is debt, then interest will be paid. Generally, it is debt. Okay. Financial system, lower cost. Flow of fund liquidity cycle is maintained, stability is there, then market effect is there. Market is not adversely impacted or affected by non-payment of your debts. Okay, this is all about your securitization. Simply meaning that whatever originator, the parties involved, who is the originator? Bank is the originator. Merchant banker is the SPV or agent who acts between the bankers and the investors. Rating agencies will rate the market as well as the house building loan portfolio of that particular bank. He will see whether the securities are proper or not, whether the people, those who have taken the loan, the mortgage is proper or not. Aisa nahi hai ki jaga dikha diya yahan aur bech diya aur makan banaya wahan. Life case I can tell you. Suppose what they take, patta, sell it as mortgage, that is equitable mortgage. You have gone and seen house is constructed, beautiful house, so you are relaxed. When the time comes you want to sell the house, when you visit it with the advocate or the people, you find that he has got 2 plots of land, he has constructed in another plot of land which he has not mortgaged to you. Now what the paper you are having, you will get the cost of the land only, nothing. Another case, he has constructed a beautiful house. You have got the mortgage on the same plot he has constructed. No road is there. No approach roads are there. These are live cases. So rating will be reduced. Okay. Merchant banker, SPV, rating agency. I told you, I have discussed investors, you and me, administrator. Is that a person appointed by the SPV to administer the securitization, or he may be a professional hired from outside to administer the securitization of the collateral assets. Next slide. Instruments of securitization, pass and pay through securities. Very simple. Pass through means the bank who receives the money will not do anything. Pass through the money to the SPV. Pay through means he will keep a percentage out of it and pass the rest of the money to the SPV. These are two types only, almost similar. And in both the cases, certificates are issued, pass through certificate and pay through certificates to the investors. Okay, nothing. Then assets and mortgage-backed security. I told you, assets backed securities are there where there is no mortgage, your credit cards, then you can ask me, what is that asset? That loan is an asset. Car loan, no mortgage is there, only hypothecation charge is there. That loan is an asset. First of all, try to understand. Asset means the loan itself is an asset. Mortgage backed securities means where any tangible security is offered as a mortgage to the banker, that particular security or securitization is termed as mortgage-based securities, which earns more benefit, and investors are mostly interested to buy the certificates, I mean your securitization certificates or debentures or shares, where the mortgage-based securities are offered in the market. Thank you. Next. Okay, thank you. What interests me more about the fee-based services is that, first of all, we have discussed how an IPO is launched, what are the various parameters to be fulfilled, or what are the different criteria to be fulfilled in IPO, different positions or intermediaries involved in making the IPO a success. Then we discuss various types of services offered by various types of corporate body for a particular fee or commission. Then we discussed what is mutual fund. Then we discussed what is securitization of the assets-backed securities or mortgage-backed securities. Friends, these are all now hot cakes in the financial market. Particularly, the securitization process is almost new, and so many companies are coming forward and involving themselves. Asset management companies are coming to purchase the assets from the bank by paying with a discount, or they securitize the assets, collateralize the assets, and formed a pool that is underlying security. Pay-through certificates or pass-through certificates are just like your derivatives. They are only contract. That itself is not an asset. That value of that particular certificate or that debenture depends largely on the value of the securities based on which these certificates are issued. Okay, this is all about securitization. Hopefully, I can just say hopefully, I have tried to do justice in explaining this particular block before you. It is really a top task. First, this big thank you goes to none other than our Khiroz sir, because the whole PPT has been framed and prepared by him. Though it is written prepared by Prithviraj Mishra, no. The PPT is prepared by Mr. K.C. Maharana, and the lecture is delivered based on the PPT is Prithviraj Mishra. And the SPV, who is the SPV here? Devashish Barik acts as the special purpose vehicle, because he is actually facilitated this online class. So a big thank you to him also. Thank you, learners. Thank you very much. But it would have been better and nice if you would have attended the class. I'm sure while viewing this video lecture, so many questions will pop up in your mind. Had you been attending this particular session online, you would have been immensely benefited. Nevertheless, try to understand from this online video lecture, and you are always welcome to raise the questions through your mails. I am the academic consultant for MCOM and Diploma in Business Banking and Insurance, and Mr. K.C. Maharana is the program coordinator, academic consultant and program coordinator for BCOM and Diploma in Accounting. So without any differentiation, you can ask your doubts at any point of time by resorting to emails or WhatsApp message or SMS or even through telephonic call. Thank you very much. Thank you once again, Devashish. Thank you once again, Khiroz Babu, for a lively and a vivid PPT I have ever come across. Thank you very much. So if you permit, I can delink from the link. I will definitely ask K.C. Maharana to add few lines as the moderator here. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for an an excellent session. I learned a lot today from this session. Mm-hmm. And I would like to also thank Debasis Barik sir for the technical support, and of course all our sessions, a big thank you should be given to all the technical persons, because they takes a lot of pain regarding SMSing the students and creating the links and contacting the resource person as well as moderator, and throughout the sessions they remains alert. So a big thank you to Devasis Barik sir, and today I think learners must have their conceptual clarity about fee based services, and regarding issue management, regarding corporate advisory services, regarding credit rating, regarding mutual fund, and finally securitization of assets. So all these aspects has been explained so in such a detailed way that I think whoever will watch the video and he or she can get immense benefit from this session, and must have the learners will get an exceptional conceptual clarity after watching this session. And again thank you to Prithviraj Mishra sir, again to Devasis Barik sir, and now this is an official announcement for the closing of the session, and may I request all to be disengaged and disconnected from the session. Thank you all.
Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.